all right, there's no way that software could be this good. I mean, SD-WAN being a software-driven technology, it's like, there's no way that it could be this good.
That's Kyle. He's a senior network security engineer for ICL, a global manufacturer of agricultural products that help feed the world's growing population. And he had a problem.
When you have 100 and some odd people pulling, you know, files from a regional location at 50 megs, that clogs up pretty quickly.
As resources became decentralized and moved to the cloud, bandwidth demands increased tenfold, leading to a lot of frustrated users. Worse still,
from further up, because I mean, everybody was saying, you know what, we're paying all this money for that little bit of bandwidth, and it's like, there's got to be a better way that we can do this.
And there was.
Tell them, didn't matter where it was.
Oh,
the world,
that's Jonathan. He's from GTT and worked with Kyle on transitioning to SD-WAN, a peer-to-peer software application that runs in the footprint of WAN edge routers and implements a virtual WAN over physical internet and private IP network transports. But back to Kyle. He knew SD-WAN could be the answer and had a meeting with GTT. And here's what he liked.
The support model and the fact that they were, you know, top five provider globally was kind of really the big situation that we were kind of looking at.
Kyle was, as any good network engineer is, skeptical, but willing to see if SD-WAN could live up to the hype with GTT's help.
Let's go ahead and give it a try on a couple of sites. Hey, if we put these 10 sites in globally and they work well, then we will move forward with the other 50 some odd sites that we have.
The result of that test?
We looked at it and it was about 10 times faster on the download speeds pulling the actual backup than it was, you know, over our traditional PLS. It was a big game changer.
So, time for rollout. ICL used VeloCloud and Fortinet.
So we're co-managed almost, if you will. They do most of the initial setup and everything like that. If there's any like minor changes or anything of that sort, we do handle it.
GTT provided Kyle with a project management group. That's when Kyle started to truly see the things that set GTT apart from others.
Having direct connectivity with Anok, having a direct connectivity with our customer support analyst, which is Rachel.
Oh, here's Rachel, by the way.
It makes it real easy to where you can just pick up a phone and you're always going to get a person, whether it's, you know, for customer support, whether it's for billing.
I have a very tight relationship with ICL. They know I am a phone call away. I am a text message away, 24/7 for them, to support anything and all that they need.
GTT, you know, you get better service model. A lot of times, you know, you call their NOC, you get a phone, or you get a person on the phone. You don't get some, you know, machine that says, hey, we'll go ahead and take your ticket. We'll create it for you. But then somebody will eventually call you in 4 to 8 hours.
And for Jonathan, he got an email from Kyle about 6 months after that initial launch, the kind of email that puts a smile on his face.
It was just a quick email just to say, hey, your network exceeded all of my expectations. I really thought this was going to benefit us, but what we were able to do far and exceeded what we thought it would do.
We can get, you know, a gig worth of bandwidth at a site for essentially what we were able to pay for the same price of a 50 meg MPLS.
Beyond the dollars, Kyle's job is now easier.
But once we actually got everything into the orchestrator and through EtherVision as well, it was definitely big as well. I mean, we can see all the analytics of, you know, what traffic is going where, how much of it, how much bandwidth was utilized during the day.
Best of all, Kyle spends way less time responding to emergencies these days.
Basically has a lot of redundancy. So, I mean, we have redundant circuits at every site. We have redundant gear at every site. So I'm not sitting here worried that, all right, you know, an MPLS circuit went down. Now it's just all done via one box. It does it all by itself. I don't have to touch it, which makes it real easy. I mean, it's one of those things that it just fails over automatically and you never see the difference.
Jonathan sees ICL's move to SD-WAN as the key to bigger things.
When our strategic group can actually put a global solution from start to finish and see that the client is, we've exceeded their expectations, they're very happy. We've been able to do something to benefit their company, to make them better. Where they're trying to go is always something that's very rewarding.
GTT went the extra mile with resources and support, so Kyle and ICL could do more with less, keep up with cloud migration demands, and be supported during the whole journey. Just think of where you and your enterprise can go with the GTT SD-WAN solution.